on agenda.
Hello, my name is Felicia, and usually I do my life lessons via audio, and my ministry business partner and sister in the faith will usually work her magic and put it together in video on YouTube or Facebook. But right now, I wanted to try out our Canon camcorder. So I wanted to see how, basically, because I know God is impressing upon me to probably start doing my life lessons doing video now. I don't know how that's going to work because I really and truly enjoy the video content that DeAja come up with when she's putting video to the words that God gives me to speak. So this is just a video diary. Don't know the usage of this, but I just wanted to get comfortable with speaking in front of a camera because if you know anything about my story, this wasn't what I foresaw myself doing. It's just amazing how God would take the weak things of the world and the despised things of the world to confound the wise and the great things of this world. So I'm just excited about what God is doing in this season for Newford, for Felicia Crawford Ministries and all its subsidiaries. Soon there will be a house of God, a gathering place where God will periodically have his people come for healing, for deliverance, and salvation. Because my focus is on kingdom, because Jesus is coming back soon. And he's coming back for a people without spot, wrinkle, or blemish. A bride, that means he's coming back for a people who's prepared for his coming. And how do we get prepared if we're not constantly given instructions, prophetic word, prophetic insight, teaching on who God is, what he's like, and what he requires of his people? We are called a royal priesthood, a peculiar people, a royal priesthood, and a holy nation for a reason. Because we're supposed to be distinct and different from the world and its people. But the sad thing about it is that when I survey the landscape of the church, I don't see a people distinctive, unique, peculiar, royal, or holy for that matter. Holiness is not even preached in today's churches. Why? When God says, "Be holy, for I am holy, and without holiness no man shall see the Lord." Doesn't preach about righteousness and repentance. Is more man-centered instead of God-centered, because God is the one to be exalted above all. Jesus himself said, "If I be lifted, I'll draw men unto myself." I know that he was referring to him being lifted up on the cross for our sins. And that's another thing. If you think you're going to get away with your sin, you will never get away with your sin. Sin will be dealt with one way or the other. And I say one way or the other, either you're going to receive the propitiation of your sin by way of that cross that occurred over 2,000 years ago, ratified by the blood of Jesus. See, God dealt with sin, the sin of the world, on the cross. Jesus bore the sin of the world. Or you're going to have to bear your own sin. Because if you don't repent and receive that which God has made accessible and the only way accepted by God to deal with your sin issue, many religions today want to say that man can be good and work their penitence in order to get to heaven, but that is not what the Bible says. Jesus is the only way that God will accept, matter, method, or way. God will accept the sacrifice, the only sacrifice God will accept for sin. And if you don't accept that, then you have to bear your own sin. And the wages of sin is death. So I didn't mean to go on with that. Just wanted to see how this camera was going to work. But I feel the Spirit of God bubbling up in me, because this time and this season, he wants his people to really understand the season, the time they're in. And many of his people are blinded and distracted by that which is considered good, but not God. There is a good apart from God, whether you want to realize it or not. Eve got enticed by a good apart from God when she took and ate of the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil. What was good for food, and it was pleasing to the sight, and it was desirable for making one wise. And Eve wasn't the only one that took of that fruit, so we can't give her a hard knock either, because Adam ate the fruit too, even though God told Adam not to. So we must understand that there is a good apart from God, and not every good is God ordained for us. We have to know the purpose God has for us in this realm. And it's very important, because Jesus, speaking in Matthew 24, said that deception will be rampant. Let me back up. His disciples asked him, what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? Because Jesus said, look at these massive stones and this beauty of this temple that the disciples were admiring. And he said, not one stone will be left upon another. And the disciples said, oh my, well, what will be the sign of your coming and of the end of the age? Because if this is going to be destroyed, then the end of the world must be at hand. But Jesus said, look, be careful that no one deceives you. Many will come in my name claiming that they are the Christ and so forth and so on. But deception will be rampant in the end time. And it's very important that you understand that deception is not going to come with a neon light identifying itself as deception. Lie is always truth twisted and corrupted and perverted. And that's what so many people in this day and age don't realize in the media and what's going on in politics. Deception. And many people take the bait of deception because they don't know truth. Why did I say that? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. John 14:6. In John 17, he says, sanctify them with the truth. Who is that them? His disciples, his followers, for your word is truth. So, in essence, Jesus is the very personification and embodiment of truth. But your word is true. Where in John chapter 1, it tells us that Jesus, the word, became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory of the one and only begotten Son of God. So, Jesus, the word, made flesh truth. If we are not sanctified in Jesus, and if we are apart from Jesus, we will never know truth. And that's why so many Christians, believers, followers of Christ, are being deceived by the propaganda and the agenda of the world because they really don't know truth. Ooh. And I'm not talking about the people of the world. I'm talking about those who's claiming to know Jesus. Ooh, what Jesus do you really know? Jesus said there will be a delusion and a lie so profound that it will even deceive the very elect if it's possible. But why is it not possible? Because of the spirit of the living God residing in those blood-bought, born-again, redeemed, spirit-filled children of God who walk by the spirit, who have the discernment to know truth and versus a lie, who have the discernment to know and see deception and distraction. We can get caught up being distracted because emotionalism. But Jesus said, don't be led by your emotions. He said, walk according to the spirit, not the flesh, because there's no good thing in the flesh. That's why I've learned over my years of living that it's a bad idea to make choices when I'm emotional. I always make the wrong choice. So I have to learn how to step back and seek God's face. The thing about David that many people don't preach about in the pulpit is that every time David inquired of the Lord, he had success. But whenever he did things his own way or listened to the counsel of his homeboys or was led by his flesh, he failed miserably. And not only did he reap the consequences of his actions, but his family and the nation of Israel. Remember the plague? Because he wanted to go and take a census, which God forbade, by the way. And even though Joab tried to warn him, don't do it, he did it anyway, and caused a plague to be released on Israel. And what about when he was up on that rooftop and he allowed his flesh to talk him into adultery and then murder? But every time that man inquired of God, he had success. Though that's a lesson for me in my life. I realized that every time Felicia did it her way, she failed miserably. But every time I consulted and inquired of God for his counsel and his purpose and his plan, success and prosperity. And that's what's going on now. It might have taken some years, but God was preparing me, was preparing us for what he's doing in this time and this season. Because we learn to listen and follow the steps in the movement of God's Spirit for our lives and our ministry. So this is just a video diary. I'm just so excited for what God is doing for Newford. For Newford Apparel, our new product, first product line, the mark will be coming out September 7, 2020. And this is the year that God said we will see what he said. But even in the midst of all this, every product and service is according to the mission and mandate of God. Because Jesus came to seek and save that which is lost. God told us to go out into all the world, making disciples of every nation, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey all that I commanded them, you. And lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age. Our mission is to be about our Father's business in every product and service we have. And so it is about kingdom agenda. So I can't wait to see what God is doing next. We got work to do, so let's get it. Too many souls are lost, too much hatred, too much religion. So get your fishing pole and get your tackle box, let's get with it. We on a mission, time to get with it. We got work to do, so let's get it. Too many souls are lost, too much hatred, too much religion. So get your fishing pole and get your tackle box, let's get with it. All of creation so eagerly waits to reveal it, of the true sons of God that will follow his word and will boldly proclaim we're his children, and will live unashamed for the gospel of Christ, and will die to the flesh, even kill it. Wave your banners up high, if for Jesus you'll live and for Jesus you'll die, is you with it? Cause if so, we got work, so let's get it. No religion, just Jesus, we're preaching his kingdom and teaching his people. Church is about way much more than a building with deacons and preachers, for walls and a steeple. Church is about way much more than theology, apologetics too much for some people. Some people need to just see you believe in a savior who bled out and rose to redeem us. Some don't believe, but eventually they will, just like Nicodemus. Some will go back and forth just like some tennis in Wimbledon, played by Serena and Venus. But we as his leaders should catch him and lead him to Jesus, so Jesus can take him and clean him, fix him, restore him and free him, so they can go forth in the kingdom. Yeah. We on a mission, time to get with it. We got work to do, so let's get it. Too many souls are lost, too much hatred, too much religion. So get your fishing pole and get your tackle box, let's get with it. We on a mission, time to get with it. We got work to do, so let's get it.
Too many souls are lost, too much hatred, too much religion. So get your fishing pole and get your tackle box, let's get with it, with it.